Hi, DrumPi version 0.9 is out, and as you may know, the biggest improvement in this release is the fact that you can now import your own sounds. But because DrumPi supports multi-velocity and multi-microphone samples, we needed to develop a dedicated software to handle large sets of WAV files, organize them, cut them, and let you tweak some key parameters. For example, a diesel snare sound, one that doesn't have the horrible machine gun effect to it, might be composed of hundreds of files. And so uploading all those WAV files through DrumPi's web interface was not realistic. We needed a proper graphical software that let you visualize all the samples, check their alignment, see how tails are cut, and so on. That's why we built DrumPi Studio, a desktop application specifically designed to create layered sounds for DrumPi. So let's have a go and create a snare sound from a bunch of WAV files. We have two ways to go about this. By individual files, every single hit from every single microphone as a separate file, or long audio tracks, one continuous long file per microphone. Let's start with the first one, which is probably the most common one. You typically buy your WAV files from dedicated websites or you extract them from your VST, as long as everything is regularly purchased and licensed.
So let's open up DrumPi Studio and click Add. By holding Shift, you can select multiple files. It's important that your files are numbered. The order doesn't matter, as long as there's consistency between microphone layers. For example, top 11 must correspond to bottom 11 and to overheads 11, and so on, meaning they are all different microphones capturing the same hit. I recommend starting with the top mic or another closed mic, because the first layer we create will be used as a reference for dynamics when calculating round robins. As you can see, all the hits are loaded in sequence. You can zoom horizontally by holding Ctrl key and scrolling, or zoom vertically by holding Alt key. By zooming in, we can clearly see how the sample was cut and check if we are happy with it. This is a simple way to review your samples. You can also audition any hit by selecting it and pressing the spacebar. All right, let's go ahead and add a few more microphone layers. Now that we have all our layers loaded, let's fine-tune some aspects. First, we want to analyze the green chart. It shows how many round robins we have and across which velocity range they are spread. The first thing I notice is that the lowest range has only one sample, so no round robins there. Let's analyze that sample. It doesn't even look like a proper hit. Maybe it ended up here by accident. Let's disable it by selecting it and pressing backspace. Now the chart has updated, and we have three round robins in that range, which is good enough. We could also disable this one here, but it's not a big deal. When a range has only one sample, DrumPi borrows extra samples from the next range, so you don't hear the same sample twice in a row. This doesn't happen for the last range, though, since there's no next range to borrow from. That's why it is particularly important that the last range has at least three round robins, to avoid machine gunning. Let's go through some parameters you might want to adjust. Transient smoothing. This is useful if your press rolls or drags or just ghost notes sound too artificial or aggressive. That can happen if you don't have enough samples in the lowest velocity range or if your snare has a very sharp attack. The scale goes from 0, which is off, to 1, which is fully on. Transient duration, measured in milliseconds, controls how much of the transient will be affected. Silence dB. This is the threshold below which samples are automatically cut. Instead of relying on the file length, DrumPi Studio trims the sample once it drops below a certain decibel level. This gets rid of silences that are often present in source samples and helps reduce sides and loading time. You can also see the effect in real time, so you can fine-tune the sample tails. I recommend zooming in to make sure you're not cutting them off too abruptly. Separation dB. This controls how round robins are calculated. For example, if it's set to 1 dB, the algorithm will group samples that differ by about 1 decibel. Raising the value makes the groups larger, which gives you more round robins. Lowering it makes the group smaller, which means fewer round robins, but better accuracy in how MIDI velocity maps to the sample that gets played. Fade out. This is a millisecond value that applies a short fade at the end of every sample, so you don't get a sharp cut. Choke time. This applies only to cymbals. It's a value in seconds that determines how quickly the cymbal decays when you choke it. Finally, crossfading. This applies only to hi-hat open sounds. It lets the sound respond to the hi-hat pedal. We are almost done. Now we just need to assign a mixer input to each audio layer. Let's save our work and click export. This will create a sound zip file, which you can load directly into DrumPi. Now that we have our sound file, let's move to DrumPi web interface and upload it. Let's say we want to add our new snare to the Golden Factory kit. Click Edit, then Add. From here, you can either upload a new sound or add a sound from another kit. Let's go with the first option. In this panel, you can override some parameters, such as mixer inputs and pregain. Then click Save. Now your new sound is available to be mapped. Let's assign it to the snare articulation. Okay, let's do a quick test and hear what it sounds like.